The first memories I have as a kid are the cozy Italian Sundays with my mom at the movie theater. My favorite movie of them all was Disney Fantasia. I watched lazy Mickey Mouse trying to teach that broom how to clean the sorcerer's cave, and I thought to myself how incredible it would be if all things around me could simply come to life. If I could teach them to do all the things I didn't want to do, including, guess what, tidying my room. Mickey Mouse's strategy seemed to be working out pretty well. The broom started cleaning the cave autonomously, and so, happy and relieved, Mickey simply went to sleep. There was really nothing to worry about. But a few hours later, he wakes up to a completely flooded cave. The brooms had been repeating the same action over and over again without realizing what was going on around them. So Mickey begged them to stop, but it just won't listen. And so all he could do was tear them apart. Unfortunately, a few hours later, Mickey quickly realizes it's too late. He has lost control. This time, more and more brooms start invading the cave again, desperately trying to make it more clean. Fast forward many years, I find myself often going back to the story as I try to think about the role of artificial intelligence in our society. These intelligent algorithms promised to bring speed, efficiency, and effectiveness, but ended up making crucial decisions on our everyday lives. Who gets better education, better healthcare, better financial support, and who goes to jail? But just like we don't expect that broom to understand what we mean by clean, it's up to us to decide and teach those algorithms what we mean by right, by fair, and by good. But thousands of decisions of this kind are made every day by data scientists around the world. What data to use, what to optimize for, and when a machine learning model is accurate enough. Well, I am a data scientist, and let me tell you one thing. You should not trust me. And you should not leave it to corporations, governments, or researchers to make these decisions for you, and not because they intend harm, but because this is not a technology problem. This is a values problem. And I believe all of us should have a say in the role of AI in our society. And let me show you why. In February 2019, Nigel Parks was arrested. He was accused of shoplifting and trying to hit a police officer. Turns out, his face was identified using a facial recognition software. But after 10 days in jail, the police found out that was a mistake. In August 2020, Sharpie Rowe is one of thousands of British students who saw their college admissions revoked. The UK government had just started using a new AI tool instead of final exams that was penalizing struggling schools in poor areas as opposed to elite schools in wealthy areas. Today, Compass is one of the most widely used AI tools in US criminal justice. So what Compass does is it helps judges determine whether a defendant should be kept in jail or not while awaiting trial. And it does so by associating a score from 1 to 10 to each defendant based on more than 100 personal factors. If this score is high enough, that defendant will be jailed. But analyzing the behavior of this algorithm showed that biased data coming in produced biased results going out. Let's take Vernon and Brisha, for example. Brisha committed minor prior offenses and no subsequent offense. Yet, as you can see, her risk score is much higher than Vernon's. So what does fair mean to us in this case? Does it mean we want to apply the same criteria to both of them? Or does it mean ensuring that they're both equally likely to be subject to algorithmic error? Because these two definitions are equally valid, but they have a very different impact on society as a whole. So you see why deciding on rules and on values is so hard. Because they mean different things for every one of us. Okay, I know what you're thinking. Isn't that why we elect our decision makers? To make these complex decisions for all of us? Well, in theory, that's true. But the problem with that is democracy is not doing that well these days. In the past few years, as a youth activist, I have worked hard with the objective of involving as many young citizens as possible in the democratic lives of their communities. And I could see how democracies are continuing to weaken. Institutions appear distant, self-protective, unreliable. Only 1 in 3 Americans trust their elected officials. The political class struggles to understand the complexity of technology and to find consensus on the most divisive matters of our time. We used to think that democracy happens once every 4 years in a ballot, but it doesn't have to be this way. Researchers and activists have studied a new model of engagement in the past few decades, deliberative democracy. And to see what that means, let me take you back to Ireland, 2015. 80% of the Irish people approved gay marriage in a referendum. But that journey started 2 years earlier, when the Irish Parliament was facing a controversial issue for Ireland's history and decided it was time to try something new. So they called a convention on the Constitution, composed of 66 ordinary citizens and 33 members of the Parliament. They came together, debated, discussed, and some of those recommendations were then turned into referendums that became reality. So what happened here? Well, the world thought these citizens were just too polarized, distant, and frankly incompetent to have an impact. They actually transitioned from observers to decision makers. And you can see and you can hear how the narrative changed from they, the policy makers, to we, the citizens. Just like many activists around the world are doing already, we can influence the political agenda by becoming good lobbyists for the causes we believe in. Deliberative democracy can happen in many forms: citizens' assemblies, town halls, participatory budgeting. And it has happened everywhere in the world, from British Columbia to Kerala, from Brazil to Denmark, from Oregon to Belgium. In Italy, Politici per Caso is trying to activate the debate on climate change. And in California, citizens' assemblies were proposed to solve the problem of homelessness. I guess what you're thinking. This woman is trying to disrupt our institutions as we know them for a new utopic, direct democracy. Couldn't be more wrong. I am suggesting we empower these institutions every day with active citizenry. So how can deliberative democracy really help us design the role of AI in our society? Well, first of all, we'd have to define and select a sample of citizens that can be representative of our diversity. And then we'd need to set up the process, involve experts, secure our decision makers' commitment, and decide the questions we want to tackle. Because if we want to design a new bill of digital rights, we'll have to agree on things like fairness, transparency, openness, explainability. We'll have to decide how data is transferred and owned. We'll have to decide who audits, who controls who. It will not be an easy process. It will require patience, experimentation, and trust in the process, even and most of all when we don't agree with the outcome. But ultimately, it'll help us understand that beyond labels, we are simply humans. I am very, very passionate about AI. I really believe it can be an incredible source of good for the world. Could AI be the next decision maker? Could AI find the best taxation policy to optimize social welfare? Or could we just leave it to AI to solve climate change? Maybe. We just don't know yet. But if and when AI will be able to find those answers, we'll need to ask the right questions. And when AI will be able to find the best solutions, we will need to agree on what we mean by best. All of us should have a say in the role of AI in our society. Now, I don't know how many of you have seen Disney Fantasia, but here's a little spoiler for you. In the end, the sorcerer comes in and saves the day. But the role of AI in our society is no Mickey Mouse game. So please, stay active, stay informed, participate in your democracy, give it one more chance. Because this time, there will be no sorcerer coming to save us. This time, we cannot afford to go to sleep. This time, we can and we must ride the rules together.
Thank you.